We have all different types of yeast, traditional ale and lager brewer's yeast. And we also have this, our bumblebee yeast here as well.
Historically, just two kinds of basic yeast have been used to produce all beer, both of which come from nature. But one of the really exciting things that's become clear recently is if you look across beers, of the things that you can vary to vary the taste, the yeast is actually what has the biggest impact on the taste of the beer. We know that if we could vary the yeast, we could alter the beer in all kinds of new ways. So what we're now trying to do is to go to nature to find new kinds of yeast to alter the flavors of beers. There are yeasts on trees, yeasts on insects. Really interesting candidates for us are social insects. We know that wasps consume lots of sugars. They consume a lot of the raw stuff that's used in fermentation.
A lot of people are hesitant to try it. Anything wild can intimidate people. But I think they become surprised by how fruity it is and how much flavor it really has compared to the kind of beer they normally taste, because the flavors from the yeast are sweeter and more aromatic and are really easy to drink.
This is really exciting because the craft beer market is all about the unique flavors and tastes and attributes of beers. What we're now trying to do, not just in the context of beer, but more generally, is figure out how do we build more on what we can learn from nature. Whether it's in the context of beer or biofuels or new stimulants, what's the next caffeine? Or new antibiotics, we're also working on that. Because the truth is, every time you go outside, you're surrounded by species of potential benefit. But they're only ever going to be a benefit if we somehow connect the basic biology and the application. And I think NC State's the perfect place to do that.